Are you looking to expand your quality time with your family and your friends? Well, I've got something really cool for you today. I'm here at Armada Games with Michael Fortino.
Hi.
Hey, Michael, how are you?
I'm having a fantastic day.
Good. Well, thank you so much for being here. Well, so tell me a little bit about Armada Games.
Armada Games, we are a tabletop game store. We do board games, card games, role-playing games.
Cool.
And hobby miniature games. We've been open for 13 years right here in Temple Terrace.
Nice.
On 56th Street by Whiteway.
And tell me a little bit about what do you do here? What do people come in for and what type of activities do you do here?
So we do tabletop games, role-playing games like Dungeons & Dragons, card games like Magic the Gathering, board games, which there are way too many to really list off, but you can see many of them here. Mm-hmm. We have great games for people who are new to the hobby and also great games for people who have been playing board games for 10, 15, 20 years.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. Yeah. Definitely. Do you have events in on the weekends and during the weekdays?
So we do have events every day of the week.
Cool.
Currently board games, our primary board game night is Monday night, though we do have a library of games. It's about 160 games that are open free to play at any time. So as long as we have open tables available, they are free. You can just come up, grab one off of the shelf, sit down. We can help you learn how to play.
That's cool.
We also have Dungeons & Dragons events 3 nights a week, Magic the Gathering 6 nights a week.
Wow.
Miniature games like Warhammer 40K, Age of Sigmar, and Blood Bowl.
Wow, that's a lot of games.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to get into playing games, or even if you have kids that might want to get into playing games, how would you recommend getting them started?
So first thing, I would actually just recommend to come on in.
Okay.
We do have a lot of board games that are also aimed at children. That are very good games that can be played by anybody, but are simple enough in their rule sets to be very easily presentable to children, very good for younger kids. Is like 6 or 8 is probably the threshold you were looking at for our style of games. And there are a lot of benefits for gaming with children because there are a lot of soft skills that are not taught in schools.
Oh.
That are taught through interactions. And this is all face-to-face interactions. Like, none of our games require a computer or two of our games require apps that are on your phones.
But the
rest of the games are all face-to-face. All of your interaction is with somebody else. So things like proactive, reactive thinking, problem-solving, how to win with grace and how to lose with dignity, sportsmanship, all of these things, there are a lot of soft skills that are good for kids. And there's also been studies that have been done in the last couple of years about Alzheimer's and dementia. And because the different style of hobby gaming, board gaming and role-playing games, all teach your brain to think in different ways.
Interesting.
It has delayed or completely, or not stopped, but has delayed the onset of dementia and Alzheimer's in many older people.
I know I'm a mom, and I know a lot of moms would appreciate something like this for their kids to do. Get them off the iPads and the computers and get them doing something productive with themselves. So what would you recommend as far as like a starting game to start with, whether you're a child or, you know, an adult or someone a little bit older? Do you have any suggestions?
Well, there's of course the big three. We call them that because they're the three games that have been around for 15 to 20 years that are very good for showing off really the mechanics of some of hobby board games that many other games build off of. And those games are Catan, Carcassonne, and Ticket to Ride.
Cool.
Those three games have been really like the staple three intro games since before we were open. Adding on games like Pandemic, which is a cooperative game, so everybody has to work together for a shared goal, or games like Codenames are like shared activity team games are very good for, again, teaching some of the mechanics, which some of the bigger games build off of.
Wow.
Like, again, going back to like Ticket to Ride, Scythe, Pipeline, all these like a little bit heavier games have the same similar mechanics to some of the ones, the other ones. So
that's a good idea. Kind of start with the big three and then work your way into the hobby. Now, what if someone comes in and there's not too many people here? Is there games for all different sorts of players, amounts of players?
Yes, I have, in our library, we have games from 1 player to 10.
Oh, perfect.
And there are many different styles of games from fantasy to space-based. You'll find licensed games like Harry Potter, games that have Harry Potter skins, or Marvel skins, as well as a game called Trekking the National Parks, which is has a bunch of facts and a map of the United States and a bunch of facts about the national parks in it. So there's even educational games.
Oh my gosh.
So
sounds like there's just so many options. You can really go crazy.
Here's the thing. Like, if you have never played any hobby board games, like you have not graduated past Monopoly and Sorry,
That's
You're
me.
Still welcome here. And perfect. Just come in. We can help you with a short conversation. We can find a game that would be good for you.
Yeah.
And sit down, show you how to play, and give you an introduction to the hobby.
Very cool. And what about like moms and their kids, or moms and dads and their kids? Is it something a whole family can do together based on a broad range of ages?
Yep, actually encouraged. We even have a homeschool group that comes in and plays games here once a week.
Oh, very interesting.
Yes, it is very much encouraged. I am a very big proponent of family game night. When I was a kid, we started off with Risk and Monopoly and Sorry because that's what was available back then because I'm old.
Yeah.
And then graduated into Spades and Bridge and Hearts and Cribbage.
Wow.
And other games like that. So very it had a very large impact on my life. So it's one thing that I encourage with other people.
That is really cool. And how did you decide to start this business? Where did the idea for the store come from?
Well, I wanted a business. My brother is my business partner.
Mm-hmm.
We had some friends at the beginning and wanted a place to play games and have fun with friends. Meet new people.
Mm-hmm.
Just before we opened, one of the other stores in the area closed, leaving there nobody in this area. So we ended up, it was
perfect. Yep. It was a perfect opportunity. And how long have you all been here for?
On October 6th of this year, we'll be finishing 13 years.
Wow. Oh my gosh. 13-year anniversary. Yep. That's really awesome. Well, congratulations to you on that. Cool. If someone wants to find out more information, come in, play some games. By the way, I meant to ask, can they purchase games here too?
Yes. In fact, that is how we stay open, is by people who purchase games here.
Right.
We do not charge for the use of the board games that we have. We don't charge for our table space unless you're playing in an event that has a fee.
Okay.
So you can come up here and play for an evening and have a very minimal fee of drinks or snacks or getting pizza next door.
Perfect. What a great opportunity for families. This is an awesome spot to come to. I'd definitely check this out. I'll go ahead and put, I know you've got a Facebook page.
Yes, we have Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All are Armada Games, Armadagames.
Okay.
And we're here on 56th Street in Temple Terrace, 10910 North 56th Street.
Perfect.
And we're open 7 days a week.
Oh, great.
Monday through Saturday, we're open noon to midnight. Sunday, we're open from noon to 10.
Perfect. Okay, well, I'll make sure to put all the information down below.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to reach out to Michael or call the store and, you know, find out what their schedule for the week is, definitely do that, guys. This is really, really interesting, really cool. So many great benefits to this. So thank you so much, Michael, for being here. Oh, one last thing. A quick tip. Do you have any suggestions for somebody that might be interested in getting into this or starting out maybe even at home if they can't come into the store?
There are a lot of games available. It can feel a little bit overwhelming trying to look through a bunch of them, but if you're looking for games, I would recommend either coming in or messaging us. Let us know.
Okay.
We're going to have a conversation with you about what things you like, and then we can start sculpting what games we would suggest to you based on your interests, because there really is a game for everybody.
Wow, really cool. Yep. Well, that's a great tip. Yep. Mm-hmm. So definitely reach out to Michael, reach out to Armada Games. Thank you again so much for being here. It was so nice to meet you.
Yep. Thank you.
All right, well, thank you all for watching, and we'll catch you on the next video. Bye.